Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. I'm Dr. El Sayed. I'm a radiology consultant working in the UK. In this video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about MDM or MDT. Many of you have asked me in the comment box to explain what is MDM or MDT because candidates being asked to mention this in their management part of answering any Viva cases, but they actually don't know what is MDM because MDM or MDT doesn't exist everywhere in the world. So MDM is a short for multidisciplinary meeting, which is an oncology meeting, and it's called multidisciplinary meeting because many members attend this examination from multiple disciplines. So you'll have doctors, you will have nurses, you will have advanced practitioners, you will have endoscopists, sonographers, and you'll have multiple people attending this, including admin staff. And I have to also highlight that in some hospitals now, they have integrated a patient member to attend these meetings so that this patient can reflect on how he feels when his case is discussed during the MDT. Having patient on the multidisciplinary meeting hasn't been applied everywhere in the UK, but some hospitals are trying this right now. So what is MDT? So MDT is a patient-centered care meeting where patient clinical history, clinical presentation, clinical performance status, and radiology and pathology findings being discussed. This will allow the medical team to discuss possible options in treating this patient and maybe suggest some options to the patient where the patient can choose which route he or she wants to choose and to get treated by. In the UK, we offer the patient choice of treatment. So although we may think this could be the best treatment for this patient, we don't actually dictate this. We just mention this to the patient, say, you've got option A, option B, and this is for you to choose because we provide them with the pros and cons and positives and negatives of each pathway and each treatment plan. The usual team members, for example, for this oncology MDT, and let's give an example of a colorectal MDT, will be the radiologist, someone like myself, will be the pathologist, someone who will be able to discuss the pathology findings for future management, and also will be the surgeon, will be oncologist, and will be nurse practitioners. And a nurse practitioner can be an advanced nurse practitioner who is doing endoscopies and taking biopsies, or can be an advanced nurse practitioner who is following up the patient in outpatient clinic, or can be even a nurse practitioner in the community where it provides community care support for this patient. You also have a very valuable team member of this MDT, which is the admin support. We call the admin support as MDT coordinator because this person, he or she, will have the burden of forming the whole MDT, notifying all team members to attend at a certain time and make sure that all case notes are there, or patient history, or radiology is being communicated to, and all pathology being gathered to be able to be discussed in this MDT. So without an admin support, an MDT coordinator who's really keen on making these meetings successful, you'll have an unproductive meeting where you'll have hours of hours looking for patient notes and looking for relevant information that might help this patient management. The room is usually big enough to accommodate 15 to 20 people because you'll have interested people or interested parties to attend, like a core member of a radiology team or pathology team or a surgery team. You may have three or four surgeons, two oncologists, and you will have a hepatic resurgeon as well in the room. And this is in the context of a colorectal MDT meeting. Each case will have a number on the MDT where we, as I said, we'll go through the radiology, pathology, clinical presentation, and there will be a recommendation from the MDT, and this will be highlighted and summarized by the MDT lead. And this will be written by the MDT coordinator, but in some other hospitals, this can be written by a registrar or a senior house officer or a house officer who's got interest in writing these data. And the reason why it's done by doctors is because there is a lot of complex information handled in this meeting, and we want to make sure that everything entered on these database is correct. One very important software we use in capturing the information is called Somerset, but this is the software I use in my trust, but there are other many softwares we use. And this software is linked centrally to patient record, to patient radiology, and to patient pathology, also linked centrally into the national reporting two-week wait office. We have a key performance indicator by discussing these patients to get a specific outcome in a specific time so that the patient can get the best possible treatment without any delay. So there should be a monitoring person or monitoring body to look at what we are doing as a trust in comparison to all other trusts in the UK. And we have to report our compliance with national cancer targets so that we get notified of any breaches to be able to act quickly on minimizing the number of breaches we have in my trust. If the MDT is not meeting the targets, then they will be given extra support to be able to overcome anything that is causing these delays. I know this could be a very new topic to you all, especially talking about the MDT coordinator, talking about the Somerset, which is a data capturing software for cancer patients, and the pathways and target time and key performance indicator. If you have any questions, please make sure that you write it in the comment box below, where I can reply to you to help you to understand this topic. It is really important that you understand these frameworks within the UK before you come to the exam. You may be referring more patients that they don't actually need discussion the MDT to the MDT, which will reflect on your bad management to this case and delaying patient management rather than being seen as a safe doctor or a doctor who knows the system very well. So I hope that I managed to tell you everything you need to know about MDT or MDMs. If I forgot anything or if you need to ask any specific question, please make sure you write in the comment box below and make sure you subscribe so that you get my next video on practices that is happening, especially in the UK, to help you become aware of the system before you come to the exam to achieve high possible results from first time. I'm sure that you know now much more better things about the MDT. You may have some questions, please write it in the comment box below. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Make sure you hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos on FRCR Viva preparation. Good luck and thank you.